In this video, I'm going to talk about the single process to iterate over every possible combinations of elements from multiple arrays. If you haven't watched the playlist, or if you're wondering why I'm doing this, all the links are in the description. So here I have my Unity project, permutations visualized. And for this video, don't worry if you don't know Unity, because in this video, all I'm concerned about is the concept and nothing else. You can do this on pen and paper. And once you understand the concept itself, pretty much everything else becomes just a tool to express those ideas. So I'm going to maximize the window and click on play. I'm also going to click on manual mode. This gives me a bunch of arrays, and we have elements, four elements in each of the arrays, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 arrays. And depending on where I click, I get different yellow boxes, different positions of the yellow boxes that represent which item that you picked for the combination. So I have, for example, I can do 0, 1, 0, 2, 3. You see the result here, 0, 1, 0, 2, 3. This is the result of the combinations that I picked, which are represented in the yellow box. And of course, I can pick whatever I want. And the goal here is to get every possible combination of elements from these 5 arrays. I'm going to reset it, reset everything back to 0. So here we have the result 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. First, let me give you the definition of the process in plain English. It's really simple. Step 1, you find the lowest possible box that you can move to the right, and you move it right. Step number 2, you reset all the lower boxes back to 0. So if we try it here, step 1, we find the lowest box that we can move to the right, which is this box. We move it right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. And in this case, there are no lower boxes, so we're done. And the first combination that we get is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. And we repeat the process over and over again. So step number 1, find the lowest possible box and move it to the right. We move it right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. And again, we don't have the lower boxes, so we're done. The next combination is 0, 0, 0, 0, 2. And it's step 1 again. Find the lowest possible box, move it to the right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. There are no lower boxes, so we're done. And the next combination is 0, 0, 0, 0, 3. And even if we have the bottom row all the way to the right, nothing changes. Step number 1, find the lowest possible box, and we move it to the right. So in this case, this is the lowest possible box that we can move. We move it right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. Reset this back to 0. So the next combination is 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. And it's step 1 again. Find the lowest possible box and move it to the right. We move the lowest box to the right. Step number 2, reset all the lower boxes back to 0. In this case, there are no lower boxes, so the next combination is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. And step number 1 again, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. There are no lower boxes, we're done. The combination is 0, 0, 0, 1, 2. Step number 1, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes. There are no lower boxes, we're done. 0, 0, 0, 1, 3. Step number 1, move the lowest possible box to the right, this box, and reset the lower boxes back to 0. Reset it. So the combination is 0, 0, 0, 2, 0. And again, step number 1, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. There are no lower boxes, so we're done. We're done. The combination is 0, 0, 0, 2, 1. This is getting a little too easy. Let's make this slightly more complicated. Let's say that we're somewhere in the middle of the process. I'm just going to randomize this. But no matter what the boxes look like, the process never changes. So step number 1, find the lowest possible box. We move it to the right. Move this one to the right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. There are no lower boxes. We're done. The combination is 1, 1, 2, 3, 3. Step number 1, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number 2, reset the lower boxes back to 0. So the next combination is 1, 1, 3, 0, 0. Step number 1, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number two, reset the lower boxes back to zero. Step number one, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number two, reset the lower boxes back to zero. Step number one, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number two, reset the lower boxes back to zero. Step number one, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number two, reset the lower boxes back to zero. Step number one, move the lowest possible box to the right. Step number two, reset the lower boxes back to zero. And you repeat the entire process over and over again until all the boxes have moved to the right. There are no more boxes at all, then you're done with the process. And it doesn't matter where the boxes are, the process repeats itself over and over again exactly the same way every single time. Instead of doing this manually, I'm now going to let the computer do it. Okay, I'm going to click on go, and we have all the results being shown up on our console window, and we're going to go through again the exact same process over and over again until all the boxes have moved to the right. I've also written this in C++, but the language doesn't matter because the process is the same, and I have the exact same setup. I have 5 rows, and each of the rows have elements 0, 1, 2, and 3. This is the exact same thing without the graphics. So if I run this, F5, okay, I get every single combination until all the boxes have moved to the right, and we have 1024 results in total. I can do the same thing with Unity. Okay, I'm going to reduce the delay, go a little faster. Okay, and we're done. We have 1024 results. I'm not going to compare every single results, but it should look exactly the same. There's only one function that's important in this script, and that is move selectors. I'm going to go to the definition. And when I say selectors, I refer to the yellow boxes that we had in Unity. And this is the exact same process. We start at the end of the array, the lowest box, and we find out whether we can move the box to the right. If yes, then we move the box, and then we reset all the lower boxes back to zero. So step number one, find the lowest possible box, move it to the right. Step number two, reset all the lower boxes back to zero. You can also see that we're in the while loop. So we repeat the same process over and over again until all the possible selectors have moved to the right. There are no more selectors or no more yellow boxes to move. Then we break out of the loop. So that's the entire process. You can do this a million times, or as many times as you want, as long as you have enough ones and zeros on your RAM. And you repeat the process until you get every single possible combination. Later, as you do more and more projects, you're going to see many other variations of this. And it's not just permutations. It's the idea of recursions, where you repeat the process over and over again. But every time you do so, you get a slightly different result depending on the data that work inside the function. And essentially, it's how your game works. You repeat the process 120 times per second, and depending on your input or your data, you get a slightly different result on every single frame. I see a lot of newcomers approaching game dev in the reverse order. They don't want to look at the data or the process, but instead they would rather look at the fancy GUI buttons or graphical features provided by a commercial game engine. But at the end of the day, they're tools. Once you understand the concepts, once you start figuring out how you specifically define certain ideas in your head, then pretty much everything becomes something that just assists you in expressing those ideas. So don't just look at Unity or Unreal. Think about what it is that you're trying to define, and think about how you can do so in an objective, logical way. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, you can reach me on my Discord server. I have all the links below. Thanks for watching. See you next time.